Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. And thank you also for bringing up this opportunity that for us it's a special important, and we focus our presentation more in the technical aspects. I think that during all this day, the different presentations explain all the process, and we try to focus in the energy subsystem and in more detail what is exactly the status now. We started in April, as Jean-Marc mentioned, but now we have a lot of work that we are doing, and we need also, we are in a very crucial period that for us it's very interesting. And we try to explain, as Jean-Marc, this first slide, only it's clear that we have two very different phases. One is this preparatory phase that we are preparing and we are preparing all the studies. Perhaps the main study that we have is the traction power simulation, but also important is the multi-criteria analysis linked exactly to all these results. So and then for the phase two, that is the implementation phase, is the phase for the detailed design and for the implementation, and also for the closing out the phase. It's our role will be more as a supervisor. Basically, the energy subsystem cover all these four main disciplines. In order to for the provider of the energy to the consumers, that we are in fact in this case the consumers, the high voltage feeding line, then the traction power supply, the overhead contact line, and the ECCS, the system that in some cases is named SCADA, but it's in this case is linked, integrated to the energy system. And it's important to note that in all cases, our solution and our simulation, also all the system are considered only one system. So all these 870 kilometers approximately are treated in our tool, our simulation tool, as only one solution on only one system. So it's important. It's important. Also, regarding the process that we are now, and in fact, this line that appears here as the decision-making process, we are just in this line. The traction simulation for us it's important first to size the system, and we are sizing the system regarding considering the worst case. Our worst case is in 2056, and also in the peak hour of this 2056. So it's important to know this, because we are dimensioning our system according with this worst case, but also we need to optimize not only the system, not only our railway system, also the location of these feeding points that for us is a key point. And this is the reason that we are, in the very beginning from this our contract for as an ENE engineer, trying to have this permanent contact with the different TSOs. And the last point of this traction simulation consider the other type of simulation that we need to do. This is the energy consumption that we need to consider and to evaluate the energy consumption from the very beginning when start the operational plan, when start the operation period, and during these 50 years of life cycle of the project. So it requires to analyze for each period the difference type of operation that is considered in the operational plan. And then, according with this, go to the facility options and provide this decision that we are now. In fact, we have these four options. Why four options and not one? It's clear because not only one provide all the best solution. Otherwise, with one solution will be enough. But it's clear that in some cases, it's 2 × 25 and 1 × 25 in a traditional solution is one part that we are considering. And the other part is 1 × 25 and 2 × 25 with SFC. Why we introduce this, we add this SFC in our studies. So it's something because it's more important for us at this stage to define perfectly this link between these two walls, the electrical grids, the power supply, and the railway system. So we need to integrate both. We need to link both in only one solution. And in order to integrate these both different worlds, we need to analyze and to consider the energy quality parameters from TSOs, and also try to achieve all these quality parameters. And this is the reason that we add in this SFC. And the reason that we have four is because each type of architecture has pros, but has also cons. And we need to analyze, and the only option to analyze is in a multi-criteria analysis. Regarding these connection points, I try to fix, because as ENE engineers, our work are focused more, under the point of view of technical, is to analyze exactly this, how we can link these two worlds. But, and this is, the four configurations. That this four configuration has different type of feeding points, but also different locations of feeding points. So each solution requires their specific feeding points. It's clear that the best case is the low number of connection points, but it's true also that other technologies achieve best solutions. For example, SFC, it's a very good theoretical solution, but we have also some points regarding the life of this system, because it seems that it's necessary to extend more than the 30 years this life of the SFCs, and then, as you know, we are considering this 50 years period of operation and maintenance. So, all has structures has pros and cons, but not only this. So we have more or less 64 different points. But for each feeding point, we have different configurations and an option to feed. So, because in some cases we have a very close from our potential connection point, we have a substation that cover one TSO substation that cover exactly this connection. And in this case, we can install and design and build this our substation, our TSS, very close to the existing substation. But in the more cases, this is not the case. So we have our substation far away or lines far away. So we need to analyze point by point, feeding by feeding point, each solution. And after that, consider and evaluate this each solution as an integrated solution. Important that it's something that I didn't mention before, but it's important also. The energy quality parameters required, it's true that we achieve with SFC, using SFC, but it's true that with traditional solution, it's not possible to achieve these traditional parameters. So we need to implement also additional solution to compensate basically the imbalance, one of the parameters, one of the energy quality parameters. And after that, and we're considering with all these four solutions, with all the pros and cons, and then we need to go to this multi-criteria analysis that, in fact, as I explained before, this is our status now. So we are now in this, involved in this multi-criteria analysis, and analyzing basically the technical solutions, the impact in the operation and maintenance, also all the aspects that it's an other key point, is environmental and territorial use, important these ramps and security targets, important the integration for all the system, because we are not designing all only energy subsystem, we are designing one railway system, so we need to integrate all this. And when we finalize this phase, it will be necessary to recollect and collect all the information regarding this selected technology and process and proceed to prepare the concept design and also the technical specifications. Basically, this is this first phase, this preparatory phase that we are now doing. So, and that's all. Thank you.